All right, family, how are you? So spoiler alert, I'm about to play a clip from the movie. Do not keep watching if you don't like spoilers. Spoiler alert.
You did this to yourself. And admitting that is the first step. You're a crackhead, Jane. Thing is, this planet and these people, they're your drug of choice. It wasn't that hard to make a universe. At first you just checked in every once in a while. See how the Neanderthals were doing.
Alright, so the movie you just saw, the clip was from a movie called The Nines. It's one of the best movies I've ever seen. And as far as I'm concerned, it is the ultimate truth drop. And it tells you what's going on in this reality. This movie was made in 2007, or at least released in 2007. It stars Melissa McCarthy and Hope Davis and Ryan Reynolds. Ryan Reynolds is the main character. His name is Gavin. The whole premise of the movie is about a man who has to realize that he is creating his whole life, that his consciousness is what is creating reality. And he lives in multiple timelines. And in each timeline, he has to realize that he is an infinite creator, creating all of the drama, the good and the bad that he sees in his life. Does that sound familiar? Yes, it sounds like what we talk about on this channel. And it sounds like the esoteric teachings that we're all fascinating by. It's an amazing movie. So the clip that we saw was him finally being explained to that, hey, man, you are a divine creator creating your life. Literally, your consciousness is doing everything in your life. This is you. This is what you created. This is the game that you are playing. You are playing your own video game starring you. This was the basic premise of The Truman Show. This was also the basic premise of The Matrix. Once Neo realized that he was the one and he can manipulate the reality around him, then he took his rightful role as the one. In this movie, The Nines, the main character is given a numerical number called 9. And that means that you're right under God. God is 10, and you are essentially God playing in the video game, and they give you the number 9. The NPCs in the movie, like Melissa McCarthy, her whole job is to keep you ego invested and emotionally invested in the illusion. That's like the NPCs in your real life. Their job is to keep you emotionally invested and for you to never find out that you are the creator of everything. That's their job. They should keep you in the dark. If the NPCs are keeping you in the dark, they're doing their job. And that was the job of Melissa McCartney, or Margaret. She was to keep the divine creator ignorant to the fact that he is an infinite, all-powerful being. So Hope Davis, or Susan, I think that's her name in the movie, Susan, her job is to alert the number 9 that, hey man, wake up, stop being a victim. You are creating everything, the good, the bad, the ugly. There's a scene where he asks, okay, why did I make it so challenging? Basically, I'm paraphrasing. Well, he answers that, actually. He's like, well, the reason I made it so challenging is because if it was too easy, it wouldn't be worthwhile to play. I mean, it's an amazing movie. I'm not doing it justice. Again, it's letting you know that you are the infinite creator. You are creating all the scenarios in your life, the negative ones, the positive ones. That's all you, whether you want to admit it or not. Okay? And that's why in the beginning clip, he asks, why are you doing this to me? And she says, no, you're doing this to yourself. Check it out. The movie's amazing. I love you all. Take care.